Let's review the mission and vision statements for Ann Street United Methodist Church. The mission statement says that when we are at our most faithful, we are making disciples of Jesus Christ by the sea and throughout God's creation. That's our mission and our reason for being. The vision statement tells us where we are headed. It reads, with passion ignited by the Holy Spirit, we will grow in disciple-making through our prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness. If we follow this vision, by God's grace, we will make disciples of Jesus Christ. But how should we go about following this vision? How do we get from the present to our hoped-for future? What steps should we take? In the vision process, these next steps are called objectives and goals. Objectives state what the congregation and its leaders must commit themselves to do in following the vision. What specific areas will the congregation work on? Goals state how the congregation will accomplish those objectives. Goals are often expressed as programs, events, or strategies to accomplish a stated objective. After the Ann Street Church Council approved the mission and vision statements last October, the vision team began to work on objectives and goals. They looked at the mission and vision that God laid on their hearts to make disciples of Jesus Christ. They considered all the things that they learned from listening to the congregation, from studying the community, and from consulting experts in the field. Most of all, they listened to God through prayer, scripture, and holy conversation. Two main objectives emerged. The first objective that emerged is a long-term objective. It is designed to address a challenge Ann Street Church is facing called the generational divide. Remember the generational divide? We learned that many people born before the mid-1980s are accustomed to a church like ours, but the vast majority of those born since the mid-1980s are not looking for a church like ours, if they're even looking for a church at all. There is a generational divide over what people want in a church and even whether to be a Christian at all. What should we do? Should we start impersonating a different kind of church, one that appeals to younger people? Your vision team says, actually, no. We need to be ourselves as a church. We need to build on the things that we do well. If we are to make disciples for Jesus Christ, we will need to provide a faith community that will appeal to those who come after us. This new faith community probably won't look like us or act like us. It will be intentionally formed to make disciples of Jesus Christ among those who are not looking for a church like ours. To help understand what this new faith community might look like, the vision team brought in the Reverend Greg Moore, Executive Director of New Faith Communities for our conference. The team learned that some new faith communities are traditional new church plants. In this scenario, a specially trained pastor is sent to a high-growth area to start a new church. That church is largely conventional in style and attracts the church-going public that is rapidly moving to the area. Other new faith communities start as small groups or house churches. In this scenario, a specially trained pastor focuses on building intentional relationships within a particular community of people who are unlikely to visit a traditional church. The focus is on being a Christian community rather than building a building. The community settings may include Bible study at a local bar or worship on the beach. Another kind of new faith community is the multi-site campus. In this scenario, a healthy mother church expands its ministry by adding new locations. In some communities, these daughter churches might be in storefronts or new buildings. In other communities, they might inhabit buildings of closed churches. It's too soon to know what kind of new faith community God will create out of Ann Street Church. We can engage in a discernment process about that when we are ready. Remember, this is a long-term objective. Forge a new faith community to bridge the gap to bring new people to Jesus Christ. We have three goals designed to help us reach this objective. The first is to define the needs, gifts, and opportunities of the community. The second goal is to partner with the North Carolina Conference in exploring what kind of new faith community will be right for us. The third goal is to eventually support an associate pastor charged with planting the new faith community. Yes, our existing congregation will need to grow before we can add an associate pastor for the new faith community. We don't have the resources yet. But as we grow our existing congregation through intentional disciple making, God can help us someday approach the objective of forging a new faith community. The second objective that emerged from the vision team can help us grow. It is to cultivate a church-wide culture of intentional disciple-making. We will focus our efforts on being faithful disciples of Jesus Christ and on making more disciples for Him. Rather than trying to be a kind of church that we are not, we will build on our strengths and focus on disciple making. Your vision team brought in Dr. Christine Harmon, Director of Spiritual Formation, for our conference to help explore what it would look like to cultivate a church-wide culture of intentional disciple-making at Ann Street. Those conversations clarify the meaning of disciple. Disciples are purposeful followers of Jesus. They adhere to His teachings in their lives. They seek to live like Him and love like Him. Disciples practice spiritual disciplines like prayer, worship, and acts of compassion. The objective, then, is to cultivate a church-wide culture of intentional disciple-making at Ann Street Church. How will we go about this? The vision team outlined three goals. First, we need to teach clear expectations for church members based on Christian discipleship. Keep in mind that church membership and Christian discipleship are not necessarily the same thing, so we will provide ample opportunities for existing members to grow in their faith through intentional Christian discipleship. We will also clarify for new members what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. This focus on discipleship is sure to bring spiritual renewal to our congregation. The second goal is to implement an effective process for matching people's spiritual gifts with church ministries. As the Bible tells us, God has gifted us differently. God calls us to live out our discipleship using our gifts. Dr. Harmon showed the vision team some processes that our church can use to effectively match people's gifts with our church ministries. Lastly, the vision team put forward a goal of having a discipleship-focused small group for everyone. Going to church on Sunday is something disciples do, but it's not the primary way people become authentic disciples. This happens best in small groups. Does this mean adding another event to your already full calendar? Not necessarily. Chances are, most of us are already involved in a group in the church of some kind. It might be a Sunday school class, a choir, an outreach ministry, or some other existing group. The goal is to provide your group with a process that will help you focus on disciple making as you do what you already enjoy doing. Or perhaps you do not already belong to an existing group in the church. The goal will be to provide you with the small group experience that interests you and that is discipleship focused. For example, you might be interested in a book club, a running group, photography club, or a group for new moms and their kids. As we cultivate this culture of intentional disciple-making, God will grant us growth at Ann Street United Methodist Church. This growth will someday make it possible to approach our other objective, to forge a new faith community to bridge the gap to bring new people to Jesus Christ. Both of these objectives will equip us to be faithful to our mission, to make disciples of Jesus Christ by the sea and throughout God's creation. Last February, your church council received and approved these objectives and goals from the vision team. They have always belonged to God. Now they belong to us, and we belong to God. With passion, ignited by the Holy Spirit, we will grow in disciple making.